Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in our Goldcrest Valley map and I was planning on just doing a quick contracting job before I started the episode, but I got some really interesting equipment that we haven't had a chance to run yet. So I wanted you guys to be able to see it. So we are doing sugar beets again, but this time we're doing the cheaper way of doing it, the two smaller pieces of equipment, rather than that giant city bus we did last time. But let me get myself straightened up here. Right there. So the front goes through and shaves off all of the tops, and then the back pulls them up out of the ground, throws them into the hopper here. So this is doing sugar beets on a budget, compared to that $500,000 setup we had last time. I'm not going to make you watch the whole thing. I'll probably time-lapse this thing. Maybe I'll do that. So, I'll see you at the other end. Okay, well this was clearly not the most efficient way to do this. You end up with unpredictable widths of rows left over when you don't go from one end of the field to the other methodically. But I probably still save time what it would take to do all those U-turns in only the span of one width. So I would have spent an awful lot of time trying to maneuver equipment within the small space available before it says we're outside of the boundaries of the field. So, let's see which of these. Looks like the last one is the widest width. I'll go for that one to see if it's enough. But with this setup here, you can't really do any curves. You've got to be in line with the front to back. So curves would take the tops off of items that the back end would never be able to pull out of the ground. No, this isn't going to do it. We got to go one more row. But I do love the animations on this equipment. Lots of moving parts. Oops, get back in there. Stop looking at the equipment, Noble. Swing it around again. Finish this from the cab. Just a sliver left. Oh, sunroof. Cool. It's coming up on 5 in the morning. I had done a few jobs before this, trying to get us some funds. So there's another 13,000, almost 14,000. So we're at 61,000 now, the different fields that I've done. Just to get us going. Did that real long skinny one next to field 5 as well. And did a couple jobs for him. So I'll be able to hopefully choose that as one of our purchases soon. Anyway, we're at 5:10 in the morning. And time to go do some work on our own place. So let's fire this guy up and see if I can remember how to drive. Been a while since I've had the game on. Just got done recording my set of the George episodes, Banished George. So I'm done with that series now. I can get back to this and RimWorld and a few other things. I must be getting used to it. I'm holding at about 35 miles an hour without even realizing it. All right, park this guy over here, right there. Lights are off, yep. So, what is going on? Now we've gone through the night, which means everything has advanced a little bit, in its growing stages. So we are. That would be the final growing stage. So if 12 and 14 are the same color, I think they are, then we're probably in stage two, essentially, the third one, but the first one is just seed. So second stage of growth. So we do need to get, I believe, one more layer of fertilizer in there, right? And can we tell? What I'm gauging it on is this little line right here that didn't get planted. So it had all of the fertilizer in it, apparently, and didn't get used up. Or rather, it had one more stage of fertilizer on it than the others have. And now that we've gone to two stages in, that one's now three stages right there. So that must be the very darkest. I must put this right here, even though I'm sure it's an optical illusion, but that color right there doesn't look like that to me. It looks lighter. I think it's an optical illusion because of the other one. So we need to get these guys sprayed, but this one needs to get planted. And I'm trying to remember if we chose what was going to go in there. Let's see, what are our choices? Let's go this route. Well, actually, let's go back here. We just had an update. I think, if I recall, I saw that we were at 1.0.3 now on Farming Simulator 17, and they added camera sensitivity. Used to stop at 200%, now it goes to 300%. I have no idea what that's going to do to me. But let me hit a save. Okay, and then back. But no, we're going over here. But anything else change? That changed. Seems like there's one or two other things in here. But I am drawing a blank right now. Well, we'll go with that. They did an awful lot of fixes. So we'll see if we come across any of them. But let's go over to prices. That's what we wanted. We've got soy is what we were going to do. Because we have got canola and barley. So canola and soy were the two best prices. Barley's going to give us a little more hay to bale. Prices are dropping though, most places. This one's rising. Don't know what it'll be when we actually get to harvest. All right, let's go with soy. So back and let's see. So that is right there. Cultivators, go get rid of that. Those are shadows. Okay. I was thinking the plow had missed all that. So cultivating is done. Put this guy away. There's all of our grass. Whoa. Yep, that sensitivity is way down there. Let me 3 DPI. Whoa, that's wild. Okay. 1, 2 DPI. That's a little better. I may not even need the DPI switch anymore with 300% increase in the camera rotation. That's much better. This guy's gonna live where? Let me think here. Out there is going to be sowing and fertilizing. So he was right in the center of this, wasn't he? So we'll do that. Park him back into here. That's the weeder there. That's the plow. All right, we'll stop right there. And V and Q. That work? That worked. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get used to this spinning speed now. All right, so we want sower right over there. And we'll hire this one out too. It's hard to do your own when you're dealing with such narrow, straight rows. We get to the much larger sewing machines, seed machines, we'll call them. Then it'll be a very different story. Let's sneak in here, hit Q, and we need to top off seed. Boy, these ceilings are. Let me get in here where the ceiling won't bounce me around. And R does which one? That is the fertilizer. Okay. So let's sneak back into there. Let's see if we can R the seed. We cannot. That is so weird why it will do it sometimes and other times it won't. Wish I understood what was going on there. There's no G, R. Now Y switches me, right? Y switches. That's the one I want, and I still can't fill it. Yeah, we've got it right there. I don't understand. So, because I've got them backwards, is that the answer? The symbol on my of the fertilizer here in the box for the tractor, 500, 100%, is the bag crates in the very back. I think I've got these backwards. Uh-huh. That would explain a lot of things if that turns out to be the case. Let's pull forward and back into here and hit R. There it is. Well, that answers that. The seeds in the front, fertilizers in the back. And now that I think about it, I think I did that on purpose because the seed was going to run out first. So I would need to replace it sooner. Uh-huh. Okay. So let's head back out here and turn that off. This will be enough. I think the hired hands will automatically turn the lights on for you. So, jumping over here. Actually, missed that a little bit. Let's go to that side. There. And hire and jump out. And let her take off and sew all this up for us. Okay, that's done. So we've got $60,000 now to spend after those contracting jobs. We want to do a couple of things. I'll do something with the grass, and we might consider doing a couple things, maybe baling part of it and making grass bales out of another part. But we've also got another stage of growth about to show up and need to think about fertilizing out here. So we got to pick up, there's a tractor, got to pick up actually some equipment. Fertilizer, I think, is the sprayer is probably the first thing to get. Can I tell what... So we decided that was the second layer of growth, didn't we? That's right. Let's go get a fertilizer. That is not turning. Let's try the other buttons. There we go. Boy, when your finger's in the wrong place of the keyboard, it can mess you up. And she has got all the lights on over there. Yeah, front and back. I think they do that until... Where am I? I'm spinning too quick. They do that until 7 in the morning. Okay, so we're just about there, and in between, I went ahead and popped out of the game and readjusted the settings on my mouse so that they're not quite so sensitive. So we're not flipping around getting everybody nauseous. So now that we've got more sensitivity in the game, well, I think that brightness is headlights behind me. There we go. Let's sneak across this thing. So we'll jump out of the tractor to be able to look around and see how it looks. Let's pull over here and take a look at our store and see what it is that we want. Right there. So let's take a look. Yeah, I can spin from the tractor to the tractor. No problem. So now it's just a matter of not spinning it too quickly for everyone else's sake. So what do we want? We want a sprayer. And they are $24,000. We don't need the extra booster tank right now. This holds an extra 1,000 gallons versus the 1,200. So it almost doubles it. You just don't have to pay for all the spraying apparatus here. But we're just going to go this route for now. Select. And no options, no colors. And it does 15 meters wide. So about 45 feet. And do you want to purchase this? Yes. Okay. Now this could mount to the front of the tractor on the way home, as well as the back. I believe. I think that three-point hitch will work in either one, which means we could bring something else back, too. I'm going to say a windrower. So, back... Windrower. Weeder's right there. Here. This little guy does one path, kicks it all up against this the shield right here, and drops a row out behind one side. This guy has a fan on both sides, kicks it to the center, and drops it out. This has, I believe, two fans on each side, which... And one of them, I think, kicks further out, so you get kind of a V shape. So all of them kick it to the center. You get one really dense pile down the middle. I would love to have that one right now, but that's way out of our budget. 28,000 is still kind of painful, too. So we want him. Then we need to get ourselves some a baler of some kind, which means a lot more jobs, or a... I don't want that one. I want this one. Or a great demand comes up, and we sell a bunch of our seed, our commodities, that's what we'll call them. Out here, this is not where I want. Darn, I'm hitting the wrong one, aren't I? Back, right there, and it's a mouse roll. That's what I'm looking for. So this guy right here, 60,000 versus 100,000. All right, so yeah, the windrower is all we're gonna get today. We get that guy. Bye. Yes. Back. Okay, back, back, back. Okay. So, let's see. Jump into this guy, fire it up. And I'm going to pop out of here. So we're going to try putting this guy on the front, which means I've got to sneak around this way. It's going to be a lot of weight for this tractor. Oh, I've got this on. Okay, didn't count on that. Let's see if we can still... Oh, this doesn't have the front three-point hitch. It's only the New Holland that does. Okay, we're going to make two trips. Let's go hook this guy up. Actually, I've got to do it the opposite direction now. There you are. So this guy, let's see here. Oh, I never knew you could do that. I thought I was moving, let's see, G, the front. I've never known this thing was slabbing down like that. That must be new to Farming Simulator 17. It's new to me. Huh, that did change. So let's head over to... So when the new update hit, everything else went back to defaults here. So I want... Dynamic vehicle camera? Or reset vehicle camera? Remembers the camera position once you exit it. And try to stay horizontal. Okay, I want this one on. Okay. And clear and clear. And I guess headlights and beacons, which is over there on that hand. There we go. Stop sign and go for it. Miles an hour. I wish. And this is the tractor with that smokestack, or exhaust stack, muffler, right in front of my face. Kind of a blind spot there. Don't remember how the New Holland looks. I'll pop back in there soon just to see. But, you see, we've got nothing in the tank in this guy, so we're going to have to go fill it up. 0% over there. How's our sewing going? Start at the other end, so we're more than halfway. Alright, that's these guys right here. There are not happening. Okay. Let's pop outside and see what's going on. Probably just forward a little too far. Right here? No. Really? What am I missing here? We're almost touching it. It will not fill. This is the same symbol as back over there. Why will you not fill? Alright, am I missing something here? Oh, yes. And this gets me almost every time when I got multiple pieces of equipment on. The G switches you from the front to the back. R. There's a lesson for you. Learn by my mistakes. Okay, turn that guy off. Fill this guy up. He's full. Take off. Let's go do the canola first. I'd love to. Let's go dump off this front loader arm. Now, how best to do that? Nope. G. But this, that's right. So we're going to, if you look at it right, see if we can, wrong button, do this. Right there, those lower sections, they swing out and become legs when you put it down. So we'll do that, swing out where we can see it. Turn mine off. There we go. So you hit the bottom. Let's go forward a little bit more. And Q. Just like that. So that's how that works. Oops. Not reverse. Not forward. The other reverse. Okay. Get out over here. Turn the beacons off. Hit the X. Start unfolding this guy. Back over here so we can kind of get a sense of how far he's going to unfold. 45 feet's quite a span. Right there. So, looks like we're heading for about like this. No, a little more. Yep, I'd say that. Yep. Tiny bit more. Alright. And V drops you. But if I were to do this, so that allows it to, right there, stay over the top of the crops, I'm guessing. Interesting. Okay. Start up and B. B didn't happen. No, not that one. Boy, feeling like a noob here. You don't play for a couple of days, you really start to lose it. Alright, there we go. A lot of keyboard commands in this game. Of course, if you're trying to fit the controls for all of these different tractors and all the other implements onto a keyboard, you can imagine that would be a little bit of a task to do. Different when you're running one piece of equipment in there and you've got just a dozen different controls and that's it. Kind of nice that these first fields aren't all that big. You get a sense of what you're doing without being overwhelmed by the volume of it. Okay, so unlike a contracted farm, this one we're going to take our time, get it just right, and use as little product as possible. Alright. Right there. Kind of hard to see, though, where the last row ended. I think it's right at the end of my row there, but I don't dare go in the cab for this one. I'm gonna mess it up. There. And overlap a little bit. Actually, now it feels like it's overlapping a lot. I would imagine a little bit more sunshine out there, and I'd be able to see this better. So you do want to get the extra layers of fertilizer in as early as possible. I can imagine if we did this, I don't know if I can, if it'll let you do it after the next stage of growth. If it does, you're not going to see a whole lot of dirt down there at all to know if you're in the right alignment. Okay, spin you around. About there, I'm thinking. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Well, it's almost dizzying looking at it from up here. At least for me, because I'm just concentrating on one point. You guys probably get to look all around the screen, but I'm watching that right edge of the spray arm. So what do you think? That last row, is it going to be one sprayer wide or just barely over? Do we go back to handle, or to cover the last 3 feet? Well, over here it looks pretty good. Let's see if we drifted at the other end. Either way, I'm going to say we're good enough. We're going to be off by just a tiny bit. I think we're going to say that's fine. In the end, we're looking at only a percent or two of the field as far as not having a full yield. So probably not noticeable. Actually, looks like we're doing okay. Okay, well, gonna make note of that. This sprayer will do this field just the right width. Okay, he's done. Fold you up. Let's take a peek. It says we missed one tiny area right there. Can we see that? Or is that something from another layer of this? You don't see anything, it's not dark. Huh, it says we're there right now. What do you think? Well, looks pretty consistent to me. I'm gonna say we're good. Alright, so over to the barley. The long way around. This thing will feel a little tippy if I'm going too fast around that corner. Done so in the field. Good. And left the lights on. Yeah. E. There we go. Let's go turn these off. There we go. And actually, let's go ahead and run it back real quick. Whoops, that's not it. Whew, stopped just in time. And what do I want here? Just kill that and let's go run back over there. Okay, and I'm curious about something before we start this up. Fertilizer. We just planted 15. And we had plowed. We had planted the oilseed radish. We cultivated that back in. And then we just planted the seed with its own layer of fertilizer added to it. So we're at the highest level of fertilization already. And the seed hasn't even started to grow yet. So we're there on this one. One more layer on this one and all of ours are done and just waiting for the harvest time. Let's get this guy going. X, open him up. Which side? Let's go to the side this time. And we'll go ahead and turn these lights off. We still have more than half a tank. Which is good to see. Actually, we're going to take this a little more like that. Boy, all of a sudden the lag just started up. Don't know why. I'm going to run through it this time. Leave it laggy and see if it clears itself up. I was playing this game with Vapa last week. And it started getting really laggy on me. It was multiplayer, so it's not something I could just turn off and start over again. And after 2 or 3 minutes, it all cleared up. So I'm going to see if we can push through this. Okay, coming up on the last row here. Still real laggy. So if it's still doing it after we finish this, then I'll do a quick restart and try to finish this episode. This one I can do from the cab, I think. Boy, still, you just can't see where things are. Takes care of that. X. Yeah, still quite laggy. Let's push all the way back to this side of the map just in case it has something to do with the map location. Not sure if that's the case though. No, it's not clearing up. So I'll park this guy, and I will do a quick restart. Okay, so what do I want? V and Q. There we go. Up out of there. All right. And I'll be right back. Alrighty, much better. Now I can move around and it's not all jittery. Okay, let's go grab the New Holland this time and pick up the equipment with that. Gotta get the wind rower. Is there anything else to get? Now, the wind rower, I don't. You know, I might need a weight in the front. I just might. I'm not sure. Let's bring it anyway. Let's see if we can do this from the cab. Yep, snuck right in there. Okay, off to the shop. Now, I'm not sure what we're going to do once we row all of that grass. We're not going to be able to afford a baler for quite a while. We could use the loading wagon and gather it up that way. I'd much rather store it in bales, though. Well, we'll row it all. And probably make a decision in a later episode. Alright, pulling into the shop here. There's our wind rower. Let's hook this guy up from the cab. Just for fun. About there. Cue. No, oh, I was a little too close. And yeah, we'll unpack it at home and see what this thing does. All right, let's go see beacons. There we go. We're good. The objective. Unfold this guy while we're rolling in. See all the pistons here unfolding. Hydraulics. And if I can turn this on up here, right? Yeah. Get a sense of what it does. Whips them all to the center. So drop it to the ground. Back a little bit so you can see it all. Imagine two more fans off to the back and the sides a little bit, forming a V. That's what the larger one will do. So the larger one would do this whole field in two passes. I'm going to take four for this one. Crushing a little croppage there. What's it going to do with this piece of wood? It's going to fling it. Does it have... Nope, it doesn't have a grasp of what's there. I kind of missed that a little bit. Let's do that again. Whoops! Oh, that didn't work. Yeah, that'll do it right there. Okay. Looks like 11 miles an hour is our peak for this guy. quite get it all this row. I'll leave a little bit behind. Well, maybe I'll make another pass through there and kind of condense and combine a little bit further. Almost got it all. Now to pull back. No, nope, not going to. There we go. You could hit this several times and actually bring it all into one single row here. And it'll keep track of it all and just pop out bales every 10 feet. It'd be so dense. But you get the idea. So we'll call that one done right there. And X, there we go. Put this guy away. And not a lot more to do this episode. We're gonna call this one a little bit short and call it done soon. And come up with a new plan for next time. Let's go put him away. Though, where do we park this one? Probably out in this guy, but we're starting to collect quite a variety of equipment here. Eventually, we're going to be having trouble getting to it. Tell you what, let's take this one over here. He's going to be fun to back up, isn't he? Alright, so let's do this nice and slow and turn in like that. A little bit closer to the wall first. That'll do. Something like that. Alright, so Q, forward. Alright, let's go drop off this weight. Right there. Okay, so I think I'm going to call this one done here. This has been Noble Rambler. I'll catch you guys later. Bye-bye, folks.